The Hold Steady Open Door Policy album review, let's do this. Legendary Brooklyn via Minneapolis band, born out of the ashes of Lifter Puller. His music, for the most part over the years, really, you know, charmed the hell out of me. They had the energy of a post-punk band. They had the heart of a heartland punk band, as well as the sincerity of, like, the best bar band you ever heard. Early albums like Separation Sunday and Almost Killed Me, I thought were pretty good. I enjoyed them. But it wasn't until 2006, as Boys and Girls in America, that the Hold Steady really hit me hard. Here, I really felt like Craig Finn and the guys from the Hold Steady really tapped into the feelings of growing up and maturing and youth, and really came through with a set of timeless tracks. And honestly, I felt a lot of the same ways about their follow-up album, Stay Positive. I still love that album. Now, around the time of Heaven Is Whenever, a lot of people started to get a little bit more hit and miss with the Hold Steady, and I completely get that. The energy of this entire album was certainly off, but I will say this, lyrically, it is still worth a listen. Now, personally, I thought Teeth Dreams was a little bit of a return to form. I actually really like the fired up energy on this album, but for me, their 2018 album, Thrashing Through the Passion, was a real misfire, for me at least. I know a lot of people actually really loved this album, but for me, I felt like this was the first time that Craig Finn and the rest of the band really did not mesh well. There was a disconnect here, if you ask me. Now, these new singles have been decent, but I do sort of have my reservations. I will say this, though, for the first half of this album, I think the Hold Steady actually really aged like a fine wine. The Feelers, I actually really love this as an intro. It goes back to basics in a really great way. It has that really fantastic bar band feel, but nothing here comes off really cheesy or too much. And my hat is completely off to Craig Finn, who after all these years can still write tracks that just hit hard. They have a way of reeling me in and keeping me hooked. And, you know, while this album may not be for me personally overall, that's one thing throughout that I don't really have an issue with. But I love how this track progresses. It's very epic and grandiose in feel. To me, this is a no-brainer. This is how the Hold Steady can stay relevant, honestly. I really enjoyed Spices as well. In a weird way, this actually reminds me a lot of their early post-punk stuff. It's very hypnotic. It's got this great bass riff. But it's lyrically captivating as well. At the same time, it has that big, epic chorus that the Hold Steady have been doing so well. For years, I love this. And honestly, I think Lanyards is one of the best tracks here. This one may not have the intensity and the energy of some of the other Hold Steady albums, but it makes up for that with so much heart and even more sincerity. Once again, I feel like this is a really super classy, up-to-date sound for the Hold Steady. It's just kind of where they should be. I think this is breathtaking. And Family Farm was one of the earliest tracks released here, and at first, I wasn't feeling it. But it has grown on me quite a lot. I think it works for them a lot. It does have a little bit more energy here. This one has probably one of the more oomph to it than a lot of the tracks here. And all around, as far as a Hold Steady track goes, this may be the most them-sounding track here. But overall, I don't know. I can't feel it anymore. There's just this disconnect with the Hold Steady that I can't get around, even though I don't think this is their worst album. Unpleasant Breakfast starts the dark, sort of boring underbelly of this album. I mean, it goes without saying, the Hold Steady aren't as punchy and fueled by this fire that a lot of their early work was. It's kind of par for the course. And most of this album before Unpleasant Breakfast has been kind of playing to their strengths. Now, like I said, lyrically, this is still money. Craig has this way of reeling you in with his tales and stories and does not let go. This is no different. And it's a shame because there's some really sweet moments and fantastic one-liners. I wouldn't say this is a complete wash, but for a few short minutes, the Hold Steady as a whole just seemed to be running out of gas. And it's a shame because those last 30 seconds where the band picks up, oh, I wish that was like that for the rest of this track. A lot of the same reservations on Heavy Covenant. I mean, the plodding, sort of slow pace of this track just does not vibe with me. Here, the Hold Steady don't even sound like a shell of their former selves. And once again, I don't think this is a complete wash either. This chorus is actually one of the best on the album. And I feel like I don't even need to say it anymore, but Craig's songwriting here is perfect. But the verses here are uneventful and just not very memorable. And the prior procedure to me is the least interesting track here. this just doesn't sound good. It's very clumsy and a little awkward. Even lyrically, compared to other tracks here, I'm not into this. And the final moments of this album are really average. Riptown, honestly, has a lot going for it. I like the dusty, broken down instrumental here a lot, actually. But lyrically here is one of the few moments where I'm grasping for something and finding nothing. Me and Magdalena, on the other hand, is one of the coolest tracks here. I love the chaotic energy here. This, to me, comes off as some really organic, off-the-cuff jam, but like a really great-sounding one. Like, if I heard this in a bar, I would say, who are these guys? It's noisy and intense at some moments, but it's also full of life and sort of fluid. It's the sort of experiment here that I honestly wish I heard more of. And Hanover Camera is just really, really safe as a finale. I can't say it's complete garbage, but like, what here is so special that the Holt said he haven't done before? I think the smooth, sort of jazzy instrumental is really likable. But Craig's lackadaisical delivery here, as well as his lyrics, which are honestly not his best here, just make this very, very safe. So I don't think this is a complete wash of an album. As a matter of fact, for the first half of this, I think the Hold Steady really find a great medium for what their sound could be right now. It's a shame that the second half of this album just shows them slowing to almost a complete halt, and just, I can't find a lot on the second half that I just haven't heard before and so much better. The energy's off, the songwriting is fine, but I don't know. Overall, I don't think this is the worst Holt Steady album. It's just an incredibly and, you know, sort of sadly safe one for me. I'm feeling a strong 6 on this, but let me know what you guys think down below. If you liked the video, be sure to give us a like, give us a subscribe, and let me know down below what you would like for me to chat about in the future. And until next time, have a great day, guys.